So discrete time systems. Okay. Now again, a system is some block that has an input, and then it performs some operation to produce a particular output, right? And if you remember how we categorized a system as being continuous time or discrete time, if for a particular system, the input to the system is discrete, and the output from the system is also discrete, okay, then in this case, this is a discrete, of course, discrete time, okay, time. Then this is a discrete time system. So how do you define a system as being continuous time or discrete time? If you have a system where the input signal and the output signal from that system are both continuous, then the system is continuous. Okay. If you have a system where the input to the system and the output from the system is discrete, then this is a discrete time system. Are there systems that falls in between? Yes, such as the analog to digital converters and the digital to analog converters, right? Those are called hybrid systems, and they are not within the scope of this course, okay? But yes, there are systems that have a combination of both, okay? So that's kind of how we define a discrete time system. Let me give you an example of a discrete time system, okay? It's not a very nice example, but it's an example. So assume that you have a financial system. System. Where, okay, you put an input amount of money, okay, which is discrete. So basically the value of that money is some integer value, so a few thousands or whatever, okay, and on a monthly basis. So basically, your time moving discrete, right? You only can put input to the system at the start of the month, and any change that happens to whatever money you have there is going to happen at also the start of the month, okay? So this is a discrete time input, right? Because it happens only at integer time events, right? First month, second month, third month, and so on, okay? And the system is adding an interest, okay, on monthly basis, and that interest is equal to, which is equal to alpha of what's in the account or the system. Okay, how can you represent this system? Okay.
You need a feedback, right?
Yes. So how can you represent this system in a block diagram? And then you will try to write its input-output equation.
Okay. What's inside or what's outside?
The system. Okay. The behavior. This behavior. How can you represent this in a block, in a system block diagram? And then we will see later on how we can deduce its input-output relation. So.
I'm thinking about you're inputting discrete values of money.
Yeah, but we don't care about the value, but the important thing is that because we are more concentrating on the fact that things happen at discrete times, right? Yeah. So we put the money at time, call it K, for example. Okay. So my input to the system is going to be X, which is the amount of money that I put at a particular time K. Yeah. Okay, and then?
K plus n, where n is 1, 2, 3.
So this is the input, and then what happens?
And then you will have...
The system?
You will have...
So what's... detail the system for me. Detail this behavior in blocks. What's going to happen? The first interest is going to be added when? After? 1 month. So it's always delayed by a month, right? So somehow I need to take the input and delay it by one sample, one shift, right? So let's call our sample time t, which is a month in this case. So I have a delay with value equal to t, right? Okay, and then that value is multiplied by alpha, right? So then this goes through a multiplier by alpha.
And then you add it to your...
Right? And then this is supposedly going to be added to whatever is inside the system, right? So basically, there is a summation here where I have the input going on one side and whatever is coming from that on the other side, and this is the output at any point in time of this system, right? Yes. What's going to be the output here? What's going to be the output from this delay?
X multiply, what are you multiplying by it, or
what's the output?
X of k minus k plus t.
What's going to be here?
T.
What's directly on the line here? So this should be what? Y of k minus 1, right?
Right?
It's not x, because x is back there, and something is added to it, and if you try to express it in terms of x, things will get complicated, right? Because this is what comes from here multiplied by an alpha, and then you try to add it to this, but to express it here, to find it here, you will get lost. So simply, this is y, right? So if this is y, then this is y of k minus 1. Y delayed by 1, right? So this is y. Ya akhwanna. T is the time between one incident and the next. So when we represent it as k, it becomes 1. So y of k minus 1, right? T is just to say that it's delaying with the amount of time between one sample and the other. In this case, it's a month. But the month is counted as 1, 2, 3 in terms of k. خلاص? يبقى k minus 1. Okay? And then what's here?
K minus 1 multiplied by alpha.
لأ, مش k minus 1. Y of k minus 1. So this is alpha multiplied by y of k minus 1. So how can we represent this system? The relation is going to be what?
Yk.
Y of k.
Is equal to yk minus 1.
Is equal to?
Alpha yk
minus 1. From one side, y of k is here, right? From one side, it's x of k. So x of k plus, because this is a summation, both of them are with positive. What's here?
Alpha
y of k minus 1, right? So if I want to put the y's on one side and the x's on one side, then this says that y of k minus alpha y of k minus 1 is equal to x of k. So this is the input-output relation of this system. You can further simplify this. Can you?
Delta? Multiply by delta and take a...
A delta B.
This
is kind of... This is kind of... This relation is a difference equation, right? Which is basically similar to differential equation relations that you do for continuous systems. Right? You remember, for example, the relations on capacitors or inductors or whatever, they have differential equations, right? dy by td or dv by dt is equal to, I equals cdv by dt, right? And so this is a differential equation between the voltage and the current. Similarly, here, because it's discrete, there is no differentiation. It's not continuous. So basically, differentiation is represented by difference. So this is called a difference equation. And that's the input-output relation of this system. It's represented by a difference equation. خلاص? Okay. So just to show you that discrete time systems, again, they behave very similarly, except that just remove continuity from your mind and start thinking discrete, right? So things will become still very analogous to the case of the continuous. So anyways, so based on this discussion, I ask you to represent a differentiator system. How would you differentiator.
Discrete?
Discrete, yes. In discrete. So what's going to be the differentiation? If you have x, and that x goes into the differentiator, you should get x of k minus x of k minus 1. That's the, so this is the input-output relation of a differentiator. So how can you do that? Can you tell me how the block diagram for this would look like? Try to do it. So I want a system which is a differentiator but in discrete. What's a differentiator? It's a system where you put the input x of k, you get the output from this system as x of k minus x of k minus 1. Okay? So how do you, how can you represent this system in a block diagram? So this is the input to the system. Okay? And this is the output from this system. So show me the block diagram of this system, similar to what we did in the previous one. Hang on. Y بتساوي x minus, يعني if you write this as y, it becomes y of k is equal to x of k minus x of k minus 1. هي دي input output relation. Anyone has an answer to this? أيوة صلحه صلحه غلطة اللي عنده عنده غلطة أو عنده غلطة كبيرة كمان
أشوف والله غلطة
كبيرة يعني حاسس إن معك غلطة لأن هو ممكن ما يكونش one time only no.
System is feed forward مش feed back. This is how you show the system, right? This is x of k. X of k, right? And then you need also x of k minus 1. So this is a delay, right? Yeah. And then you take this x of k minus 1, which is going to be produced from here, right? And you subtract it from, so this is a summation, you subtract it from x of k. Then your output y of k from this system is going to be equal to what? X of k minus x of k minus 1. Right, so x of k minus x of k minus 1. So it's a feed-forward system. It's not a feedback system. Yeah. You branch and you take a delayed version and then you subtract it from the input. Okay? I hope you can, not only for discrete-time systems, by the way, get practice doing representation of systems in block diagrams. They are quite useful tools, not only in signals and systems, in any other material. Even for your final design project or whatever, okay? Anyways.
How does this represent a differentiator?
إيه هو الدفرنشيتر؟
ديفن
فرنشيتر. هم؟ إيه هو الدفرنشيتر in discrete time? Yeah. ما تعرفش؟ You don't know? طب من حوالي 10 دقائق. Okay, so let's go quickly over like a couple of few things that we can do in the remaining like 5 minutes, and then we'll stop and continue next time. So number one, again, in terms of systems, we are more concerned with linear time invariant discrete time systems. Okay, and the linearity as well as time invariance are defined exactly the same as we did them for the continuous. Okay. But I'm not going to ask you to prove that a particular system, discrete system, is linear, or a particular discrete system is time invariant. Okay? But you know, you know that the linearity and time invariance are defined exactly the same, except that we use discrete representation, and there we use continuous representation. Okay? So for a system to be linear, it has to be additive and it has to be homogeneous. And for a system to be time invariant, it means that shifting the input with a particular k node is going to shift the output with the exact same k-node value, right?
Yes.
Instead of saying t-node, we say k-node, because k is our time index. That's the only difference. So now we are using just discrete time representation. Now for linear time invariant systems, number one, the impulse response of the system. Okay, call it H of K is equal to the output of the system when the input is said to be a delta function, right? So same definition, okay? To get the impulse response from the input-output relation, you go for the input-output relation and you substitute the input by a delta, but a discrete delta in this case, and whatever you get for y is going to be your h, similar to what you did in the continuous time case, exactly similar. Number two, for a linear time invariant system with an impulse response H, okay, so if I have an input X of K going into an LTI system that has an impulse response H of K, then the output Y of K is given by the convolution, but in this case, it's a discrete convolution. X of k convolved with h of k, which is equal to the summation for m equals minus infinity to infinity, x of m, h of k minus m. Okay, so very similar to the convolution in continuous. Again, we use a dummy time variable. We call it m instead of the tau that we had there, right? And then the first one becomes x of that dummy variable m, and the h is inverted and shifted as a function of m, and it's shifted by the time index k, which is the time index of the output that we want to achieve, right? So similar, the k here is replacing the t there, and the m here is replacing the tau, and the integral is replaced by a summation, okay? And graphically, it has the same operation. So you can put the two discrete signals, and then one of them is as it is. The other one is flipped and shifted by a value k. And then you start doing multiplication and addition and shift, multiplication, addition and shift, and so on. Okay? So it's exactly the same graphical as well as calculation operation, except that you have to deal with summations here instead of integrations. That's the only difference. Yes? We described that last lecture. Last lecture. Okay? Okay. Now. Yes, we will discuss them quickly. So, again, quickly, the convolution is commutative. Okay? It's associative. Yes. It's distributive. Okay, so all these properties similar to the continuous time case. Okay, the time shifting property is the same. So time shift, which says that if I have x of k convolved with h of k, and this produces a y of k, so if this is the case, then x of k minus some shift m convolved with h of k minus some shift n is going to produce y of k minus m minus n, right? So if you shift one only of them, the output is going to be shifted with the same value. If you shift both of them, the output is going to be shifted by the sum of both values, okay? So that's the time shift property. Again, it's exactly similar to the continuous time case, and also the width property. Okay. The sum minus one. Diamond fill integer, you have this minus one thing, okay? So if you have x of k convolved with h of k, and the width of the first was m, the width of the second was n, so basically the first one has m points, and the second one has n points, then the result of the convolution, which is y of k, is going to have a width equal to m plus n minus 1. دايما في الانتجر عندنا minus 1. Okay? Because there is one overlap that we have to remove. You cannot, I mean, eventually, you cannot end up with a situation where they are non-overlapping, the two segments, right? You keep on shifting while performing convolution until there is at least one overlap between them. Once they stop overlapping, which is the case that you will have m plus n, there is no output. The output is going to be zero. So that's why the output is up to m plus n minus 1, because there has to be at least one overlap. In the continuous, this does not appear, because a single point in the continuous does not show. Okay? Like an infinitesimally small point, okay? But in the discrete, it appears, okay? So I think I'm going to stop here. So these are the properties of the convolution, and I'm going to stop at this point, and next time we are going to continue with some other system properties, and then we'll start talking about the interaction between discrete-time systems and discrete-time signals, particularly in frequency domain representations, with nice stuff that we will not do yet, and we'll do